All right, so I'd like to now explain a little bit or introduce this system that we're going to use in this course. It's a dynamic geometry package. It's called GeoGebra. It's one of many dynamic geometry packages. Other ones are Geometry Sketchpad, CAR, or Circle and Ruler, Cabri, Cinderella. This one has the advantage that it's free. You can download it for free. And it's also quite nice in that it combines aspects of geometry with algebra, so it's quite a good tool for you to use outside this course as well. So let me see if I can play around with this and show you how it works. Okay. So here's GeoGebra, the basic setup. You see that we have some sort of buttons up here, various tools. And okay, we have the usual file, edit, view. We have various views. I guess we're in the geometry view. There's something called tools, which I'll explain in a second, and some help tutorials. Okay, so we'll ignore the algebra side here and just have a look at the geometry side. I'm going to make some constructions. So let's go up here to a button. Okay, that's a point button. I've just made a point. It's called A. And now I've made another point, B. And now let's join those points with a line. So I'll click this line through two points. And now I'll go to A and B. So I can make a line there through A and B. And then I will also click again on B and another point C. And then on C and A. I've just made three lines. Okay, I can escape from the tool. If I go back to move, then I can move any of these points around and everything moves around. Okay, this is the main feature of these things, is that things are movable. So you can see different possibilities. Notice on the left-hand side that we have some information about the various things. So we have three points which are in blue. They're A, B, and C. And over here you just see the coordinates of those three points. We also have the three lines, like that line there is the line little a. And over here you actually see its equation in the x, y coordinate system that we have here. Okay. If we move the points around, the equations move around. All right, let's do something now. Let's use another tool. Let's say construct a perpendicular line from a point. I'm going to choose this point, and I'm going to choose that line, and I get an altitude of a perpendicular from the point to the line. I'm still having that tool there, so I can press this point and that line, and again, a second altitude. And I can also get the third altitude, point, and opposite side. There are the three altitudes. And I hope you're not surprised to see that those three altitudes meet in a point. And let's call that point something. So to make a point, I should probably go here. If I click under here, I get some more options. So here's intersect two objects, for example. So if I click on this line and say this line, I've just made the intersection of those two lines. Okay, that's the ortho center. In fact, let's color it something else. So I'm going to go to right-click object properties, color. Let's make it red, all right? So you can see it's red now here, and over here its algebraic thing is also red. If I move A and B around, the ortho center moves around. All right, so I've just made this construction. Now I'm going to see if I can make a tool that does that same construction all at once. So I'm going to, having made that construction, so I'm going to go to under tools here. I'm going to click under tools, and I'm going to create a new tool. And I'm going to specify the output objects. The output objects is going to be this point here. And the input objects is going to be the three points of the triangle that I started with. Okay, and I think that should be enough. So anything else? Next, finish. Okay, I've created a new tool. You see there's a new little button that's up here? That's now a new button that I've just made that will make an ortho center of a triangle. Oh, so I'm going to click on this and see if it actually works. Okay, so I'm going to make a triangle. One, two, three. To see that triangle a little bit better, I'm going to make it into a polygon. One, two, three. So now you can see that triangle that I just made. And you can see that the tool has automatically made the orthocenter of that triangle. Let's do some more fun things. Maybe I will delete that one to make it a little bit less crowded. So let's delete, delete, delete. And we'll go back to this one here. Okay, let's look at some more intersections. Intersect objects. Suppose I look at the intersection of this line and that thing there. That's the foot of the altitude. I'm going to look at the three feet of the altitudes. Okay, so I've got three new points down here, the feet of the altitudes of this triangle. And I'm going to make a circle through them. How do I make a circle? Right here somewhere is the circle construction tool. It has various options. I'm going to make a circle through three points. Okay, so I'll click on that. And now if I click on E, F, and G, I get a circle that goes through those three points. Does anybody know what that circle is called? That's a very important circle for the triangle. That's called the nine-point circle. And I will, maybe I'll show you the triangle again, just so we can see the triangle. A, B, C, A. Okay, there's the original triangle. So this circle has the property that it goes through the three points that I constructed with, but it also goes through some other interesting points. And I'm going to find them by using some input here. Now down at the bottom here, there's this input line, which we haven't used before. Okay, I can tell the machine to make constructions by appropriate instructions here. So I'm going to type midpoint. Or can I see? It's already gives me the choice. So midpoint, point, point. And if I go, okay, let's say A and B, A and B. So midpoint A, B. I've just created that point H. And you can see that that point H is on the circle that we've just drawn. So of course that's true also for this point down here, that's also the midpoint, and this point here will also be the midpoint. There's another interesting midpoint that's around. So if we look at the midpoint of, let's say A and D, so the midpoint between A and the orthocenter, that one there, that's also on the circle, as you can see. So there's three such points. There's that one there, there's that one there, and there's that one there, along with the 3 foot of the altitudes, and the three midpoints makes 9 points. So every triangle has this special circle that goes through 9 interesting points. And that's a classical construction that you can illustrate here. All right, now let's have a look at some other features of GeoGebra that's going to be very interesting for us. We're going to maybe clear things up here. Maybe I'll select some stuff and delete it. Okay, we're back to the empty XY plane. I'm going to type in down here an equation. How about 3x plus y equals 5? There's the line, 3x plus y equals 5. But I can do more fancy things. I can do something like x cubed plus y cubed plus 3xy equals 0. And I get this cubic curve. That cubic curve is a very famous one. It's called the Folium of Descartes. It's a famous French mathematician, René Descartes, who was basically the founder of Cartesian geometry, studied this cubic curve. This is a degree 3 curve, as you can see from the equation, because there's some x cubes and so on up there. All right, so what else we can do is we could maybe select this and maybe point on object. I can create a point on the object, hopefully. Oh, there it is. Okay, so I've just made this point A. And you can see that I can slide this point A around on the curve that I've just created. Now, with any luck, I should be able to make a tangent. This is a very nice construction that GeoGebra allows. So if I write down tangent, and I guess I want point on curve and curve. Okay, so the point on the curve is the point A, and the curve was, I think it's little b. That's the name of that curve. And maybe I will make that a different color, let's say blue. All right, so the program has for us automatically created the tangent to the curve through this point A on it. And if I move the point A, well, pleasantly, the tangent will move along with it. So this is a very great and powerful tool that classical differential geometers of the 17th and 18th century would have killed their next door neighbors to get a hold of something like this. All right, so there's now another aspect that I want to just mention briefly. Under view, there's an algebra view, there's a spreadsheet view, there's a CAS view. That stands for a computer algebra system view. That's like a little version of Maple that you can use to make some computations in this setup, so Maple or Mathematica. So it will allow me to make sort of algebraic manipulations. So I'm not much of an expert on this, but let's just try something. Let's look at A plus B, and let's say cubed. Oh, illegal error. Oh, that's probably because, okay, we're already using A and B up here, so that's not allowed. All right, fine. How about X and Y? X plus Y cubed. Let's make cubed. That's a multivariate function. Okay, so maybe I should write it here. Sorry, let's try that again. X plus Y to the fourth. All right. Okay, you can see that it's actually expanded that out for us. And here along this toolbar that appears when you're in this particular view, you can do things like substitute, expand, factor, keep the input. So I think if I substitute, solve numerically, we can differentiate, delete, evaluate numerically. So you have this sort of extra computational tool that that will help you in computations. All right, so since we're studying the differential calculus in this course, having something like this will be a big help for us. So I'm going to encourage you all to get a copy and play around and become a little bit familiar with that.